In ancient Rome, Emperor Nero hunts Christians. In prison, the Apostle John sees the apocalypse. In Jerusalem, Jews revolt in all-out war. For them, it's the end of the world. One Christian woman holds the key to a war of angels and demons that will change the future forever. Chronicles of the Apocalypse is a series of biblical novels by best-selling author Brian Kadawa, telling the story of the Book of Revelation in the first century. Four supernatural novels. Read them all, from Tyrant, Rise of the Beast, to Judgment, Wrath of the Lamb. Available in ebook, paperbook, and audiobook at Amazon.com. That's Chronicles of the Apocalypse by Brian Kadawa at Amazon.com.
So the coming in Matthew 24 is the point is that in the Old Testament, Yahweh says he comes on the clouds every time. I can go over examples. Every time God judges a nation, a city, or a people, he calls it coming on the clouds. And, you know, I'll jump to just an example of that right now, because I think that it's probably, in a way, I'm starting with the most difficult passage for most people, because I was able to, in Matthew 24, I was able to understand how a lot of that could be fulfilled in the first century, but this certainly seemed to me like, oh, this had to be the second coming, right? But so the point is that in the Old Testament, whenever God judged a nation, a city, or people, he called it coming in the clouds. So for instance, if I can find my examples here, forgive me. Here we go. Okay. Gotta have notes, because I'm just not a Bible genius like I ought to be. Isaiah 19:1, the oracle concerning Egypt. Behold, the Lord is riding on a swift cloud and is about to come to Egypt. And Isaiah 19 is all about God judging Egypt. He comes on the clouds. When God came against Israel using the Babylon armies, in Jeremiah, he says, behold, he comes like the clouds, his chariots like the whirlwind. When God comes against Nineveh using the armies of Babylon, it says, Yahweh takes vengeance on his adversaries. His way is when whirlwind and storm and the clouds are the dust of his feet. And listen, there are a dozen of these examples. But my point is that the Bible says when Yahweh comes to these nations, comes to these cities in judgment. So the fact is, and if you're a Christian, you believe Jesus is Yahweh. So technically Jesus is coming on the clouds to those nations, cities, and peoples, see? So to say that Jesus comes on the clouds to a city is not to say that that's the physical second coming, because the coming on the clouds is a metaphorical poetic term used in the Bible to describe judgment. And not just that God's judging them. God didn't literally come to Egypt or Nineveh surfing in on a cumulus nimbus, right? All those passages right. Very much describe God using pagan armies to accomplish his deed. When he goes against Israel in Jeremiah, what armies does God use to be his hand of judgment on Israel? The armies of Babylon. What armies does God use when he comes? And look these up for yourself. Jeremiah 4, read the whole chapter. Read Isaiah 9:19, the whole chapter. When God judges Egypt and comes on a cloud, it says he uses the armies of the Assyrians to do it. Mm-hmm. And they are the ones who judge. So God uses pagan armies to do his will, to perform judgment on nations, cities, and peoples. Therefore, the argument of preterists is the coming of Christ on the clouds is the same language in Matthew 24. That is Christ coming in judgment on Jerusalem to destroy the temple. Why? Because of Matthew 23, because the Jews had the blood guilt of all the prophets of history on them, the first century Jews and them alone, had the blood guilt of all the prophets. Why? Because they killed the Christ. So when you reject the Messiah and kill him, that's the ultimate crime of history. God's going to come, judge Jerusalem, destroy the city like Jesus said he would, etc. So that's what preterists are saying. So that doesn't have to be the second coming. Now, full preterists will say that is it, but partial preterists say no. I mean, Jesus comes in many ways. If you read the gospel, if you read Revelation, Jesus said, each of the seven churches, I'm going to come to you if you don't repent. I'm going to come to you if you don't repent, right? So this notion of coming to judge does not have to be the second coming at all. And that's the basic viewpoint from which I'm coming from. But again, you know, I'm even open in my viewpoint, but that's what I will defend.